Hello everybody, this is Simon here, and what I want to share with you in this video is about an advice on psychological growth. And essentially the advice is that you do not have to walk around and feel that you have to entertain issues or problems in your own mind. So essentially, of course, if a problem or an issue or a challenge arises in your life, you can deal with that. You can use your creative intelligence to deal with that. But what I mean is that more in general, you do not have to walk around and feel that you have to entertain a whole, number of issues or problems in your own mind. Rather, allow your mind to focus on the things that you want to create. So your mind becomes an instrument, a servant of the things that you want to create in your life out of joy, out of inspiration, and out of happiness. So essentially, when you believe that you can use your mind to create what you love, then you align your belief system and your whole psychological structure with the knowledge or the understanding that you can create what you love. So you then tap into that energy, like inspiration or happiness or creativity or joy, when you wholeheartedly believe that you can use your mind to utilize those functions, those energies. But if you believe that you first have to solve issues or problems, then the energy of your mind will run towards trying to solve those issues and those problems. And again, if a problem or an issue arises in your life, you can of course deal with those things. But the thing with the human mind or the ego is that it kind of plays a trick with us. It plays a trick with itself, essentially. And what it does is that it tries to, it creates an issue or a problem. And it tries to convince us that the issue or the problem exists external to the mind. So essentially, the mind makes up an issue or a problem and tries to convince itself that this issue actually exists external to itself. But in reality, the mind made up or created that problem in itself or by itself, and that's where the solution exists within the problem. Because if you realize the problem is self-made and not something existing in the external world, rather it's self-made, you can deconstruct that problem by realizing that, oh, I actually don't have to create this problem in the first place, and therefore I do not have to solve it in the sense, in the external world or in the practical reality, you know. So what this does is that it frees your whole psychological structure to focus on the things that you want to create rather than things that you think you have to fix. So, because trying to fix things is a kind of energy that is very limiting. But creating things naturally aligns you with the energies of creation, the energies of source, the energies of inspiration and creativity and self-empowerment. So essentially the advice is that, you know, dwell on the things that you love to create, rather than dwelling on the things that you think you have to fix. Because essentially you don't have to fix a whole list of problems. You don't have to fix a whole world or something, you know? So essentially, when you also believe that you don't have to fix things, you will naturally see in the reality around you that things are fine. Things are, so to speak, the way they should be. And when things are the way they should be, we can rather focus on rejoicing and finding inspiration in happiness and creating the things that we love. So the psychological advice, or the advice on how to grow psychologically, can be summed up with: allow your mind to tap into its creative function and stay in its creative function. So, because the mind's original or natural function is to create. So when you allow the mind to be creative, you're really just allowing the mind to be what it is intended to be, what it really is. And then you start to tap into that creative energy. Your mind becomes an instrument for creation, for creating things. And then you will, you know, your mind will be full of creative inspiration rather than attempting to fix problems. And when you start to receive that creative energy from your higher self, you also gain a lot of energy in whatever venture, whatever endeavor that you are embarking upon. So whatever you do in your life, you will receive a whole lot more life force and a whole lot more creative energy when you are allowing your mind to simply be returned into its original creative function. So that's the message I have for you in this video. Thank you for watching, and have, as always, an amazing day.